what we're doing on national forests is really to benefit a diverse range of flora and fauna, and this project is just one piece of that. So we're harvesting timber and we're getting a product out of that, but by doing that we're also creating habitat for birds and bees. Even though the log landings are sort of this degraded small piece, we're trying to do everything we can to sustain populations of wildlife. So the Pollinator Habitat and Log Landings Project is really about putting pollinator habitat in highly degraded sites where log trucks have been driving over them to help get wood out of the forest. When we remove trees from the forest, they're brought to log landings where they're loaded onto trucks to be moved to the mill. It creates a lot of disturbance on a very small part of the landscape, and they're usually really slow to revegetate with plants.
So in each of these forests, we got together, we visited all these landings in person, we took notes about all of them. Really interesting to see all the different forests and the different landings and what they could look like. The grad students are essential to this project because not only do they help get the work done, but they bring a fresh set of eyes and open minds to the project.
Oh, I have to catch this, I'm so sorry. I absolutely have to catch that. Can I get a show of hands? How many people thought number one was a bee? Okay.
I mean, just the general being informed is amazing. I can go home and, you know, teach my daughter the difference between a bee and a fly, even if it doesn't affect my science generally, which it does. Just that knowledge is really empowering.
And they are able to help us do things that we couldn't do without them being present. And they are finding things with the soils that some of our treatments are really being very effective in alleviating compaction, much more so than others, in particular the subsoiling and biochar application. The combination of those two seems very effective, and that's very good information. So one of the things that was of interest along with those treatments is we wanted to know, do we get good vegetation or revegetation that will eventually come back onto these sites if we do some of these soil mitigation treatments? Does it come in on its own? Or can we put in some seed mixes that would give us some plants that produce this nice habitat, especially for pollinating insects?
Yes, she's got the, you know, the two yellow bands.
A lot of times it will just be plant focused or soils focused or pollinator focused, but really everyone's been in it since the beginning, and that's actually what makes this really kind of a unique project, both from the research side and also from the management side, because we have folks from civiculture, timber operations, botany, soils, all coming together to sort of make this work. And so really the idea is these are very small little patches, but if you multiply them across the landscape, we're really creating a difference for pollinators.